Hello, assalamualaikum and a very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today I would like to share with you this live video with regard to the idea of creating an online certificate that been attached with the QR code. And then after that, we are going to demonstrate it using the smartphone. Okay, I have a smartphone over here that are going to validate those electronic certificate that are going to be generated by our LMS, Learning Management System. For those who are very new in this channel, please do consider for subscribing, share, and also like these videos. And then you can also put your comment down there in the future so that we can help you to explain more about the LMS, how to create, how to perform LMS during your teaching, and how to manipulate those LMS mechanism so that this become useful and interactive manner for you as a teacher or educator in sharing those knowledge with your students. Okay, let us begin. So if you can see here, we have the example of LMS system, Malaysia Open Online Course. And then I'm going to log in with the credentials of administrator over here. And then I'm going to go for site administration. I need to install it under the plugin over here. You can go to plugin and then you can install the plugin. Okay. So the plugin actually available in the Moodle plugin directory. So you can go to moodle.org and then slash plugin. You can search for certificate. And then some of the certificate plugin are available for you to use, but for this particular training and this particular example, I may want to focus on the simple certificate approach or this plugin lah, simple certificate, because the version is quite high, which is reported 3.8, which is can consider very useful for us to use, because my Moodle version is 3.9. So this kind of integration or this kind of setup after this are considered to be accepted by our system. So you can just click download and then everything will be downloaded for you. For your information, I already installed it, but if you do not install it yet, you can just go to the install, plugin install, and then upload those plugin. Okay, you can upload those plugin, MOD underscore simple search, and then go for open, upload this file, and then you can click continue. And then waiting, install plugin from the zip file, and then you can follow through for a time to time. Okay, so theoretically speaking, I'm using the administrative account. So we already complete it, and then we can shall try it for our use. So let me just go to one course over here, go to turn editing on, and perhaps I would like to remove the existing one. So we start from zero. All right, so what happened actually, you can go to add an activity or resources, and then we can request for simple certificate. So I got two, custom certificate and simple certificate. For custom certificate, maybe I'm going to share this idea later on. So for the simple certificate, it's very useful for us because we want to generate a electronic certificate, e-certificate. And then this particular certificate also will be available with the QR code that already been generated by the system. So if this certificate is very important for the students, therefore they are employee and they go to job interviews and so on, it's very useful because they are anybody else in the world can scan for it and try to understand their authenticity of those certificate. So the next step after we upload the layout of our certificate, then you may want to copy this the whole text over here. And then this text actually available using the Moodle plugin. And then inside the Moodle plugin directory and also explanation, also they give that idea. And then you can just click the arrow button down here and then proceed with this HTML codings, and then you can just place it. You can just paste it, the code that I already share with you in the description below. Okay, and then congrats username, they will using some sort of greeting for these students, and then go to show more, and then perhaps you can adjust the certificate text horizontal position. In my case, I'm going to use 30 and 70. Why I said that, we are going to observe the productions of this certificate soon. So go for the other option. Okay, print certificate QR code, yes. Print code in the first page, yes. That's mean when the students print it, then the certificate will be available with the QR code in the first page on the similar page that we have on our certificate. Then you can also set for restrict access. This one is very useful, especially if you want to test the competency module of the student first before they can able to download their certificate. So let us click this create certificate button, because it's going to generate the idea of our data. So you see, the position is kind of acceptable. The QR code also is being generated on the top left corner. However, our logo should be positioned not in this area, maybe on the another side here, on the right side of this certificate. Okay, maybe you want to make some sort of changes. Please be my guest. Just go to the edit setting over here, and then you can proceed with the show more button over here, and then you can adjust accordingly. Let's say I'm going to insert as 20, and then for the certification text will be 80. So that's mean we try to make some sort of changes for the direction of X and Y of this word. What I mean by word is the word, the write up on our certificate must be positioned nicely. Okay, so I think this is kind of acceptable. Maybe you want to shift it to the left a little bit, up to you. But for the interest of time, everything is already set. So now I'm going to input something with regard to the achievement setting. So basically I just want to specify whoever want this certificate should do something. Okay, in this example, I'm just going to put add restriction for the activity completion, which is they just read the introduction and so on, and maybe they can just tick it automatically, it's available for them. So let us begin to login using the student's account. So this one is very thrill, because you can straight away understand how this electronic certificate being generated. All right, so go to your site home and then choose for your course. So now I'm a student, you see this certificate is available. Let's say as default is like this, I cannot tick the e-certificate unless I already finished the activity introduction is marked. That means I'm going to look into something on the introductions. Then I'm going to click here. Let's say you have a quiz, then you can set for the grades. If you pass this evaluation and assessment, then the e-certificate are going to be generated for you. So we can go for e-certificate over here. And then they are going to open something like this, and then go to the get certificate. And then the certificate will be produced automatically. Using your own name, you see this one being generated based on the student's name. So this student's name may Mael Tutor. So you have complete the year, the course name, which is the pathology 2, and then on the date, which is today date. But you can change the date according to your preference. Maybe you want to indicate the date is today, or the fixed date. It's all up to you. Okay, now let us go to the next part, where I would like to share with you how I would like to scan this code. Okay, why I'm waving like this and shaking my phone, just to make sure that you can see it in a live condition, and also in the truthful manner how this thing is being scanned. Okay, I'm going to open my scanner over here. And then we are going to scan the certificate now. So after the certificate being scanned, so something like this is being created, or something like this will be emerged. Then I may want to open it by click the open link. Okay, so just open it with Chrome. So this is the certificate verification process is already being indicated on my phone. So the students in the future can go to verify the certificate, you see. So the verification certificate is success, and then the students are able, or anybody else who checking this certificate can download those certificate. And the important thing is this certificate also have the watermark copy over there. You can see lah, copy. Right, it's very useful, especially if we are trying to create some sort of online mechanism, and then this online mechanism will be certified by a certain peoples, and then this process require a competency module. So by using the QR code under this example, actually we can proceed to understand the step. So let us do some recap. So the first step, you have to install the plugin. After you install the plugin, then you can activate those plugin. And then one of the way to use the plugin is to request for add activity or resources. Then you find out the widget which are indicated simple certificate. And then you have to insert your certificate and then do some sort of manipulation, changes, put some restriction, position your word, and then make sure you have the ability to use the template. You can use any free software, or you can create it using Microsoft PowerPoint, for example. And then you can upload everything, and everything done. So if the students achieve and already comply with the restriction access that you set, then the student are able to fly and get those certificate. So please do not forget to go for these simple certificate text tools. So I'm going to share this link for anybody who wants it. And then if you want to change the text, for example, to make the text much more bigger and so on, you can just change this one, you see. 1.5 can be changed into 2. And then this one also same. That's mean we are trying to change the font size that already been generated by our system. Okay. So I think that is cover almost everything with regard to the how you can create an online form. Sorry, how you can create an electronic certificate. And this electronic certificate also poses the QR code that can be used further by the external people to make some sort of validation for that particular certificate. So I really hope that this live videos enjoys most of you, and especially from my colleague that usually manage the RMC, Research Management Center, because in the end of the day, it's very important for them to set all of this certificate for our participant. Okay. With that, thank you very much. If you got any question, please just comment under the live button over there. They got the live chat, and then you can comment, and then you can also leave a comment under the comment sections of the YouTube so that we can answer it, or I can dedicate it a few minutes to hours just to give you free content on solving your LMS problem. Okay, with that, I think happy learning, and try your best to understand this certificate generation using LMS, Learning Management System, via Moodles, and using the simple certificate plugin. Okay, thank you for the simple certificate text code, which is I also put some linkage from some link that I gathered this simple certificate code from a video of our colleague with regard to the LMS. Okay, so that is all for my live video tutorial about how to install plugin, simple certificate plugin, and thus create electronic certificate with the QR code validation process. Okay, I hope you find this video useful, and see you again next time, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe, like, and share, because through that we can further grow and share all of our knowledge and experience to help you in managing your LMS. With that, thank you very much, and see you again next time. Bye-bye.